Hiking in the wilderness is all fun and games until you take the wrong step. In the winter of 2019, a hiker stumbled into quicksand in Utah's Zion National Park. He was buried up to his knee in cold mud. It took hours before he and his crushed leg were rescued. But what would have happened if he had been trapped there for 24 hours? Could he have sunk completely? This is Your Body On, being stuck in quicksand for 24 hours. Quicksand is formed by sediment, silt, clay, or sand mixing with water. Even air trapped in sand can be a dangerous combination. And since the materials are packed together, it looks solid on the surface. But if you apply any pressure, like from the weight of your body, it quickly collapses. Help! Just being partially submerged is extremely hard to break loose.
What?
Physicists have calculated that if you want to pull out your foot at a speed of 1 centimeter per second, you'll need the same amount of force required to lift a small car. Oh, and calm down there, buddy. Quicksand can change its viscosity in response to stress. Continued motion makes it stay in a liquid state. So, the more you move, the deeper you'll sink. 1 hour. Your legs are stuck in quicksand and they've been submerged for 1 hour. By now, the compression is causing you to develop crush syndrome. The pressure your legs are under is making the blood flow decrease. Without proper circulation, your cells need to change how they work. They start by generating high amounts of lactic acid in a process called anaerobic metabolism. Since there's little to no oxygen in quicksand, your legs' cells will also have a hard time maintaining a healthy chemical barrier. Potassium and other chemicals will start leaking out from the weakened cells and begin seeping into the surrounding tissue. While you're stuck, this leakage from damaged cells will stay contained in your legs, but once you're freed, these toxic chemicals can make their way to your organs, leading to respiratory distress and liver damage. Freedom doesn't look that great after all, huh? 6 hours. Okay, you've been stuck there for several hours now, but you're only buried up to your waist. Do you think you'll keep sinking like you see in the movies? Quicksand has twice the density of your body, which means science is on your side in slowing your downward motion somewhat. But to counter that sort of good news is the fact that the thickness of your legs means they're still going to sink beneath the surface.
They in trouble.
Once you reach your belt line, your lungs begin to add a natural buoyancy. They become two life preservers that keep you afloat.
Oh my God, it's up to my mouth.
At least you'll be able to keep breathing. Phew. 12 hours. Okay, you're halfway through this challenge. The night is falling and it's getting a lot colder. You start shivering. You're feeling weak and confused.
Get me out of here!
That's because while you're stuck in the cold, wet sand, your body is losing heat 25 times faster than normal. Yeah, usually your core temperature is about 37 degrees. Once it hits 35 degrees, you could get hypothermia. If your body temperature keeps dropping, you might lose consciousness or die. 24 hours. Okay, now the sun is rising. You managed to survive the night and now you're seeing daylight at the end of the tunnel for this challenge. But not so fast. Now the sun is burning too bright. You are very thirsty. Your body needs water to produce sweat, which helps lower your body temperature. But you haven't drunk any water in the last 24 hours.
Help!
If your body temperature rises above 40 degrees, you could have a stroke. Plus, toxic substances would keep building up in your body because there's no water to flush them out. This can cause kidney failure. That doesn't sound like a happy ending for this challenge. Maybe you can try and submerge yourself in other liquids. Like, could you survive underwater for 24 hours? We'll find out on another episode of Your Body On.